Hi everyone. Today is Thursday, the 14th of December, and it's late in the afternoon, and yes, I just had a shower. I wasn't feeling well overnight. I think I gave myself a little bit of food poisoning, which sucks, because I went out and had what I thought was a good sandwich, a bacon chicken ranch, and I just wonder if maybe the chicken wasn't cooked all the way through or whatever. But anyway, I'm here. It's a little bit later in the day, and I notice I kind of blend in. We're going out for the chamber Christmas party later, and I've got a nice sweater that goes over this. It's not black. But anyway, I want to talk about disappointment. Let's talk about disappointment. So we all get that place, right? Like, I can't believe I'm not passing these tests. I just don't understand this theory. Why isn't this working? Why didn't I get the job? Why, right? Stuff happens. It's not necessarily in our control. And we get disappointed. So I think you're allowed to take a few minutes and wallow in your grief. Absolutely. You're allowed to do that. But don't stay there. Find a way to get out. Redirect your energies. So I'm going to give you one of my experiences. In 2010, I was nominated for the board of NCRA, but I lost the race. Someone came in, they nominated her, and they won. And I was really disappointed because someone nominated me, and I was excited to serve because, you know, this profession has given me so much. But my peers said no. And I'm like, okay, well, I'm really disappointed. And I cried a lot that weekend, a lot. And everybody was really nice to me. I'm like, I can hold it together except for when you start being nice to me, and then I'm going to start blubbering, you know? So I was really disappointed. And I took my ball and went home for a couple of years. I literally said, you know what, if you don't want me, I'm not giving my time to you. And that was my response. Whether it was healthy or not, I don't know. But after 3 years, which conveniently was the amount of time that I would have been off the board, things started happening, right? I went to Intersteno and I won my first gold medal. And I decided that it was time to get back into the volunteering side of things. So I was able to, granted, I did wallow in it a little bit, but I decided to redirect my strengths elsewhere. And one of the things that I kept saying to myself is, you know, when you serve on a board, you are tied to the board's rules. And if you don't serve on a board and you have opinions that differ from the board, you can say them without any issues coming from the board itself. So that's my thought process on that. So what about, I didn't pass that test. Well, how do you regroup from that disappointment? Did you take a look at what you did that caused the non-pass? I mean, was it something in proofreading and that you just went too fast and you missed all the little words? Was it something with theory? Did you just hear something wrong? Is it some type of thing that you can work on? For example, for a lot of us, brief forms really help us stay on speed. So maybe you could focus on your brief forms so that the next test is a pass. And I think that's where we all need to remember, this is a one-time thing. It's not a forever thing. Yes, it's disappointing. It's sad when we don't pass, right? Disappointment is hard. When people let you down, when associations let you down, when family lets you down, when life lets you down, when you were really hoping for something and it just didn't pan out, whatever that is, make sure that you get out of the doldrums. Try not to spend too much time in that sad place. It's not healthy. And, you know, my philosophy has also been, you know, obviously there's something better waiting around the corner, whatever that is. We don't know what it is, but this particular thing was not for you at this moment. Redirect your passions, redirect your energy, redirect your thoughts. All of these things, once they've been redirected and you can start applying the new methods to the new things, maybe you won't have a disappointment the next time around. And so I'm dealing with a disappointment right now and trying to figure out my best response to it. And I've always been someone who is a bit of a maverick, hence my nickname in the 100 Days group. But I'm also someone who believes in doing what's right for the right reason. And so I am going to do things the right way through process. And hopefully there will be a good outcome. If not, then I'll have to redirect and regroup and figure out what I'm going to do from there. But I think that wallowing in it and being mad is not good for you, right? It causes stress. Like, I've already got too much cortisol in my system. I don't need more, right? It may cause you to not sleep well, whatever it is. So it may cause you to snap at people because you're stressed out. So don't wallow in it. Redirect yourself and find yourself a new direction to focus your practice, to focus your work life, to focus your volunteerism, to go out and try something new, whatever it is that takes you out of that disappointed place. Move forward. All right, guys, I'll talk to you soon.